Kaya, and nice to have your company at lunchtime. Parliament is back, sitting for the first time this year, and there is a lot on the agenda. Joining us with the details is political reporter Chloe Boris. Chloe, how has the week begun?
Well, the parliamentary year never actually starts here at Parliament, but down the road at church. Politicians put their differences aside, but that unity is over the second the service ends. Now, there is a lot on this week, and the first week will be dominated, much like the rest of the year, around the cost of living crisis, especially with the Reserve Bank expected to lift rates again tomorrow. So there will be some legislation introduced around housing affordability. There'll also be law changes in the wake of Scott Morrison's secret ministries. And this morning, there's been a lot of debate about the voice to Parliament. Now, the news poll out this morning says 56% of Australians would vote yes, while 37% saying no. And that suggests the PM's prayers may be answered this year.
Will not have an impact on most people's lives, but it might just make some people's lives, some of the most disadvantaged people in our country, their lives better.
Now, before question time heats up this afternoon, there will be a condolence motion for late Senator Jim Molan.
Thanks for that, Chloe. One of Melbourne's largest Buddhist temples has been destroyed by a devastating blaze. Firefighters were called to the Bright Moon Buddhist Society Temple in Melbourne's southeast at around 8 o'clock last night. 10 News First journalist Brendan Crew has been following the story. Brendan, what's the latest?
Winnerolda, this blaze has absolutely devastated the local community. Fire investigators are still trying to piece together exactly what happened, but they don't believe it to be arson. It's likely it's been caused by a candle or a firecracker. The blaze broke out just before 8 p.m. last night. The temple completely engulfed in flames. The fire quickly took over the whole building, with the flames spreading through the wooden structure. No one was inside, thankfully, and no one was injured. The last person inside was a cleaner. Firefighters were on the scene quickly, with more than 150 people battling the blaze. It took them around 3 hours to bring it under control. A warning was put out to nearby residents as a precaution because of the thick black smoke and embers coming from the fire, and dozens of homes around the temple were evacuated. The local community have been visiting the shrine here this morning, showing their devastation and sadness at the loss. There's around 600 urns inside, with family members' remains that are feared to have been lost. We spoke with one woman whose father's ashes are inside. Take a listen.
My dad's urn is in there, and we've got a separate place for mum. You know, mum is 88, and I was hoping that, you know, we've got somewhere that we could come and you know, be with dad. And the temple has been, you know, been here a long time. It's really, really special place for us. Yeah, and I just feel such a big loss. I cry myself to sleep, actually.
Narelda, fire investigators say the structure isn't safe and they may need to demolish it before they can get inside, but a devastating loss here in this community.
Thanks for that, Brendan. NRL stars Latrell Mitchell and Jack Wighton have apologised for their behaviour after being arrested and spending the night in police cells in Canberra. They were seen together this morning boarding a flight to New Zealand ahead of preparations for the All-Stars match. Samara Gardner has the latest.
While charges have been laid against Latrell Mitchell and Jack Wighton following the alleged 30th birthday party punch-up, so far both players are being allowed to play in the upcoming NRL All-Stars clash. That will be played in New Zealand, and this morning both Latrell Mitchell and Jack Wighton boarded a plane bound for Auckland. Neither player answered many of the questions thrown at them as they passed through the airport. Latrell Mitchell kept his comments very brief. Here's what he had to say. Are you disappointed this has happened? While there were concerns Latrell Mitchell might have been injured in the scuffle, he seemed in good spirits this morning, as did Jack Wighton. We saw both of them laughing and talking together as they walked through that airport. More videos have emerged of the arrest of both men as questions are asked in relation to the police response to this alleged incident. Even still, both players have been charged. They'll have to face court later this month as the NRL's integrity unit carries out its own investigation into this alleged fight and what impact that might have on both players for the start of the season remains to be seen.
Samara Gardner there. Billionaire Australian mining figure Andrew Twiggy Forrest is calling for a tax on unrecycled plastic. Forrest has unveiled new research showing single-use plastics made from oil have surged around the world by 1 kilo per person in just 2 years. His Mindaroo Foundation found 139 million tonnes of plastic was generated worldwide in 2021, up from 133 million in 2019. The UK has already introduced a plastic tax, though experts say many manufacturers are happy to pay it rather than change their practices. New figures out today show the number of Australian teenage boys falling victim to sextortion is skyrocketing. Kids Helpline says 78% of calls about the issue have come from young males over the past 5 years. The practice involves offenders tricking victims into sending sexual images of themselves online. Victims are then blackmailed to pay money or continue sending sexual content. Parents are urged to remind child victims that it's not their fault. Seek support and report the crime to police. Police are piecing together the final moments leading up to a 64-year-old man being hit and killed by a truck in Adelaide. Emergency services were called to Melrose Park around 9 last night. Despite their best efforts, the pedestrian couldn't be saved and died at the scene. The 31-year-old truck driver was not injured, and major crash investigators are asking anyone who may have witnessed the collision to call Crime Stoppers. Two frightening attacks on a speed camera operator and his car have been caught on camera in Melbourne. A man wearing a balaclava and armed with a tomahawk can be seen splashing white paint over the vehicle before he allegedly threatened the operator. Earlier the same hour, a man was seen approaching on a bicycle when it's alleged he spat at the car window and punched a side mirror. Fortunately, the operator wasn't harmed. Police believe the incidents are linked and they're appealing for more information.